Let's say you wrote a prophecy about the next 10 Super Bowls, who's going to win? And you're right 9 times. The first 9 times is exactly right. But you didn't subscribe your name to the paper. You said that Thomas Jefferson wrote this centuries ago. So just before the 10th Super Bowl, someone says, "Hey, wait a minute! This is all a forgery. It's a forgery. Thomas Jefferson didn't write it." Okay. So the dispute, a forgery means that someone claims that someone else wrote it. There's a dispute over the authorship of something. But what does a dispute about authorship have to do with the content? It has nothing to do with the content. So in other words, if the next 9 Super Bowls are actually predicted by something that's written now, what does it matter who wrote it? As far as the accuracy goes, it makes no difference what name you ascribe to it. So Saint Malachi of Ireland is purported to have written this prophecy of all the remaining popes in history, and the church's response is that it's a forgery. But what does that have to do with the content? What does that have to do with the accuracy? Forgery means there's a dispute over. They say, well, Saint Malachi didn't write it. Well, whoever wrote it is pretty darn accurate. So who cares who wrote it? What we're concerned about is the accuracy of it. So I find the trying to sweep this away, the church trying to sweep this away, it is so clumsy to be absurd. Nobody cares whether who wrote it. What we care about is the accuracy, and is it accurate? So what's not being addressed by the church is the accuracy. They say, well, that's a forgery. That's a forgery. Okay, so we don't know who wrote it. Okay, that's fine. Now, what about the accuracy? They don't want to address it. They don't want to address it. But, what was it? Cardinal Spellman was so obsessed with the prophecy that he got in a boat and filled it with sheep and went up and down the river in Rome, in Tiber River, I guess, in order to fulfill the prophecy, hoping that he could be the next pope. They take it very seriously. The church takes it very seriously, actually, because it's been so accurate. It's been uncannily accurate. It's very uncanny, really. And, of course, we now hear that Pope Benedict is stepping down. And at the end of February, and there's going to be a conclave, and at some point in the spring, the next pope will be supposedly picked. And Malachi's prophecy is that, or whoever's prophecy it says this is the last pope. This next pope is the last pope. And it's going to end with the destruction of Rome. It's going to include massive tribulations, very bad stuff. So, to say the least, there's a lot of trepidation. Based on the stunning accuracy or correlation between these little blurbs that were written so long ago, and the popes, it's very, very, very amazing in many ways. So we can't just say it's a forgery and then let's move on. I mean, that is so self-serving. It's ridiculous. There's no logic to it at all. It's just devoid of logic. It's imbecilic. It's appealing to the imbecilic, which is beneath any dignity at all. It's not serving the body of Christ at all to dismiss something in an imbecilic manner like that, saying it's a forgery, and then overlooking the fact that it's been an accurate forgery. So, that's really sad that we cannot face up to the times like this. But we can face up to the times, and it wouldn't be the slightest bit surprising if the next pope is the last pope. What I have seen is this president is going to be the last president, very likely to be the last president. We're going to hit a dead end very soon. So, our job is to face up to history, to face up to the times, not to bury our head in the sand and try to just sweep everything under the carpet. So what we want to do is we ask ourselves, well, what do we do about it? Prepare for the worst and hope for the best. So that's what we do. We prepare for the worst, hope for the best. I hope there are no problems. Absolutely. but I'm unwilling to forego any preparation just based on some stupid dissimilitude of saying, oh, well, it's a forgery, so don't worry. Don't worry. There's too many other red flags all around that cause a great deal of concern, actually. So how do we prepare for the worst? Prepare for the worst. Well, I've said there are ways to do this. There are ways to do this. And in the effort to prepare, there have been a lot of breakthroughs. I've experienced a lot of breakthroughs recently. Major, major, major breakthroughs. And just one just this evening, just a huge breakthrough, is I suddenly saw the non-necessity to pray for any outcomes. And I understood that why that is true and how that is a preparation for the vision of Christ, preparation for the vision of the overlay, of the illuminated self-illumination of everything. Because it's the self-illumination of everything, it is the overlay, it is the vision of oneness that solves our continuity problem, which is our only problem we have, only problem spirit has. And the what's happening in the world makes absolutely no difference whatsoever. Let's say that everything was lit up with a self-illumined light. Everywhere you looked, you saw this beautiful, beautiful light, unchanging, coming from everything. Whether something's in motion, whether something is going up or going down, or something's big or small, valuable or we call not so valuable, whether something is healthy or sick or alive or dead, or everything is giving off this beautiful light. So the question is then, what does it matter what outcomes are taking place in existence? Why does that have any importance whatsoever? And the answer doesn't have any importance, none. The highest mantra that I know at this point says, don't pray for outcomes. Don't pray for outcomes. I don't need any outcomes. Spirit does not need any outcomes to be reminded of what it is. How could it need any outcomes to take place? It needs to have the continuity issue solved, but that's not solved by outcomes. Reality is not something that is producing outcomes. So that solves the mystery of the most mysterious appearance in the history of the planet, in my opinion, which is Sri Anandamayi, the most mysterious appearance. It's completely off any chart you could ever even draw up. It's so mysterious. And her thing was, she said, it doesn't matter what happens. Just let anything, whatever wants to happen, let it happen. It doesn't affect me in the slightest bit. I said, what you talking about? Let world wars happen, let all this stuff, it doesn't have any effect, and that's true, it had no effect. How is that possible? Well, it's certainly possible if she was seeing the self-illumined nature, self-illumined vision, the vision of self-illuminement of everything, where everything will be equally beautiful, that the light coming off of everything is equally beautiful. And knowing that the only problem we have is the continuity problem, simply abiding in that vision and reassuring us that that's all we need. Outcomes don't matter. Outcomes don't matter at all. Not in the slightest bit. That's the real high teaching. That's real effective teaching to hear this. Not only do we not need to pray for any outcomes, outcomes don't matter, good or bad, it doesn't make any difference. What we are doesn't need outcomes. We're not in need of any outcomes whatsoever. So, in that case, it takes the whole weight of the world off our shoulders, doesn't it? It takes the entire weight of the world off our shoulders if we can see it that way. Literally, the entire weight of everything, of existence, drops off like that. Which is necessary at this time because the whole world is going to go up in flames. And if you are attached to outcome, you are going to be in big trouble, worse than big trouble. You are going to be just in trouble, period. Just mark it down. However, if you are not attached to any outcomes, you are free. You are free right now. You are free. So there is a way, there is a focus we can have that will truly work. And I will truly work on that focus as it's coming into focus for me. It's coming into focus very strongly. It's like the microscope is, oh, there it is, I can see it. Don't pray for outcomes, don't pray. Pray that you have a vision that is completely unaffected by outcomes. That is the prayer, Okay, don't pray for any outcomes at all in the world. Pray to have a vision, a perception of that which is unaffected by any outcomes and resolves a continuity issue. That is the only prayer you have need to make, and the only prayer that really has any real sanity to it. So, we can lock in on this now, and we need to, because events are going to happen more quickly than we presume. Look at this shocking announcement by the Pope. Who saw that coming? And so that immediately brings in the Malachi prophecy of the next pope is the last pope, and it immediately brings in the tribulation period. Absolutely does. Meaning it can happen very quickly. One of my main themes throughout the years I've been taping is that it's going to happen more swiftly than we expect, so we don't dare drag our feet. We have to push full throttle right now, 100 miles an hour, pedal to the metal, which is I've been doing, I continue to do, and even more so now than ever. Because it is happening right now, and we have to have the means to sidestep this. In other words, do not be attached to outcomes. And it may seem like that's impossible. How do we do it? It is not impossible. It is not. I'm seeing it very clearly. Very clearly. Ah, that's it. And it, yes. Yes. If you were to see everything being self-radiant, giving off this luminous, radiant, beautiful, steady, unbelievably beautiful light, spiritual light. If you were to see that, and no matter what is happening, time, place, situation, it's all still giving off this light. Then again, what does it matter what is happening? The outcomes that are taking place, good, bad, and ugly, doesn't matter at all. Has no effect on how you feel, no effect on what you're seeing, no effect on the reassurance you're getting from seeing that self-luminosity. No effect whatsoever. And by seeing that light, and seeing it's all one light shining through everything, you'll be reminded of the oneness of reality. And then you can say, ah, this was just all a dream. It was all nothing in the first place. It's never been anything at all. I've not been in any danger or threat whatsoever. And you can drop dreaming altogether. And then, of course, outcomes are, well, we realize there never was any outcome. It was all a fantasy. But short of that, short of this vision of oneness, then what people are going to be doing, they're frantically praying for outcomes, praying for outcomes, praying for outcomes. And when the outcomes don't happen, they're just going to fall apart. Because what we don't realize is that when we pray for an outcome, we draw the thing that we're praying against to us. To us. Because we want to overcome it. We say, we need something to, really based on deeper than we know, that we have this, we're trying to overcome something. Now, what does spirit in reality need to overcome? Anything? No, nothing. Did God create spirit with some big problem that it needs to overcome? The answer is no. So that should clue us in that the way of trying to overcome something is not the way. It is not the way. That's the false way. That's the way that leads to trouble, leads to destruction. Don't pray to overcome anything. In fact, pray that you see the vision where all outcomes become totally irrelevant. Totally irrelevant. Good, bad, and indifferent. Don't matter. Doesn't have anything to do with what you're seeing, with what you're experiencing. And that's why you get these great appearances in the world of those like who simply are blissful no matter what's happening. Doesn't matter what's happening. Nothing affects their bliss at all. And you say, how's that possible? I mean, here's a really good outcome and there's something terrible and you feel the same way no matter what's happening. How is that possible? Now we know, at least I know, how it's possible. And it's not something difficult to explain. And you can easily know it too. It's just that the urgency of the times is bringing this out in us. The urgency of these times is so severe. I'm under so much stress right now. I have a hard time sleeping. I'm waking up at 2:30 in the morning and just like, ah. And it's just like my nerves are all jangled. And it's just a very, 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 I'm nervous. My body is all nervous. My legs are kind of, I'm on a move. It's like, wow. I get this feeling like the crunch is going to hit real soon. And I mean, it's just like there is this hiatus now in the church. There's kind of things been thrown into limbo, and that could be a time when the puppet masters, boom, push their buttons. The goddess of destructivity starts pushing her buttons here and throws things into turmoil and chaos. I mean, the world has what, over 1 billion Catholics or something, and they form huge, majority, huge amounts of people in a lot of countries, and it's a big deal around the world actually, and turmoil could ensue. Turmoil could ensue. Organizations without a head have a hard time focusing. So the times are tenuous. They're tenuous times right now, and made more and more so all the time. All the time. So I personally am jittery about the times. Very jittery right now, which is pushing this contemplation, pushing this prayer, pushing this focus. Say, what is the answer? Come on, let's get it right now. Right now. Need it right now. And pray for the vision that is needs no outcomes. That is indifferent to outcomes. Pray for the high indifference that is completely indifferent to outcomes. Doesn't matter because everything is shining. Everything is shining. Let's say you lit up your house and everything is like there's not any darkness anywhere. Perfect light everywhere. Light, 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 light. So are you going to walk around worried about light? No, you're not going to be worried about light at all. And so, what does it matter what room you go into? It doesn't matter, does it? Everything's lit up, totally lit up. Go to the kitchen, you go around your yard, there's no darkness anywhere. So why is it, what does it matter where you go or what you do or whatever? Wherever you are, you see the light, it's all lit up. And in the case of the vision of Christ, you see the self-luminosity of everything. So, what does it matter if it's a stone? Or a tree, or a car, or a building, or a road. Everything has the same self-luminosity. So it doesn't matter what you're looking at, a stone, or a sunset, or whatever. Or it doesn't matter what the events of the world are not changing the self-luminosity of anything. So this answers a lot of questions, actually. The secret of secrets, the secret of secrets. And again, how can people not be affected by death? The great guru is not affected by death, and they, because the dead body also has the same beautiful self-luminosity, and the decaying corpse also has the same beautiful self-luminosity. Everything, the living and the dead, and everything in between, the sick and the young are growing. Everything has the same self-luminosity. Everything. Everything, everything, without exception, without exception. So how can any event be important? If there was some exception, then you could say it's an ex there's an exceptional situation where events are important, relevant to the issue of continuity. But if there's no exceptions whatsoever, then how is anything important? How is any event important? It's not. It's not important. And there drops away the burden of the world. And when the burden of the world drops away, certainly there's the bliss. There is the bliss. And the self-luminosity provides the bliss too. There's just this effortless ease of bliss without burden anymore. And the only thing that's shocking is that this has not been promulgated more in the world, because it's the answer. It really is the answer. It's completely self-evident that it is the answer. But everybody is still trying to get outcomes, spiritual outcomes, trying to get enlightenment. That's an outcome. They don't quite understand what's meant by it. But doesn't matter. Outcomes don't matter. When you see it this way, outcomes are not an issue at all. And so we have this answer now. We have this answer, and we can go from here. So actually, this is a great response by the Holy Spirit to the events of the times. where it's being recognized that it's go time, and because it's go time, we're asking for give us the ultimate mantra here, give us the ultimate focus. And results don't matter at all. Give us the vision where results simply don't matter at all. Give us that in which results don't matter. And if results don't matter, how can we fear the future? You see, how can we fear anything? There's nothing that can take away our bliss. There's no events or occurrences or outcomes that can take away our bliss. There's no outcomes that can take it away. So how can we fear anything? Why should we fear anything? From a spiritual standpoint, from a standpoint of continuity, of solving our true problem, why should anything present a problem to us then? It doesn't. It doesn't. And so life then becomes blissful. I mean, it's just, there's nothing to stop the bliss. There's nothing to get in the way of bliss. There's no outcomes to get in the way of it. So again, come what may, let it, whatever comes. Let it come. I'm not paying attention to asking for anything. I'm not asking for anything to come, not asking for anything to go away. That's again, Ananda Mayama. Those are her words. Just, I never ask for anything to come. I never ask for anything to go away. Just let whatever comes. Let whatever goes away, go away. Makes no difference to me whatsoever. None. Now we're going to be able to see this. Why? I see it very clearly. It's very clear. Very easy to see, actually. It's just that you can't try to turn it into an outcome. Therein lies the problem. You see? You say, okay, I got this vision of Christ, and also, okay, now how do I turn that into an outcome? You don't. You don't. You don't turn an outcome, because all it does is solves a continuity problem. That's all it's for. That's all it's for. So the outcome is to set down all dreaming, all hypotheticals, all together, set them down, all of them. But that's the final step is taken by God to release all of that. We don't even need to worry about that. So we're not aiming for any outcome. We're aiming simply to abide in this bliss, abide in this vision. That's all. Not aiming for any outcome. Nobody needs to aim for any outcome. Nobody. So the problem is when we start to think that the ego says, okay, well, how can we use this blissful state to produce an outcome? We're not using it to produce an outcome. So gurus are not trying to produce an outcome for us. They're trying to show us to abide in this state that outcomes don't matter. So I always wondered, how come gurus don't help your circumstance? My circumstances have not been really seem like, wow, I'm just not getting any help. It's because the help is coming from the angle of, don't pray for outcomes. Pray for the vision in which outcomes are irrelevant. So in other words, the wisdom is in charge of the spiritual path instead of the ego. The ego is looking for outcomes. Say, how can I get a better outcome? Whereas real wisdom, Holy Spirit says, you're not trying to get a better outcome is not it. That's delusion. Instead, see a vision in which no outcomes matter at all, one way or the other. That is the way that saves. That is the way that saves. So the effort is to bring about that vision. It is not to necessarily put you into some nice place or solve the problems of your life. I mean, my problems of my life haven't been solved. I mean, I've been kept alive. That's about it. That's about it, really. The ice is like super thin. I haven't fallen through the ice, but it's still super, super thin. And I always wonder, how come, why it's so stressful? Because the angle of approach is to see that outcome, see the vision in which outcomes don't matter at all. And then from that point, there is no ice, really. Whether there's ice or no ice or whatever, none of it matters. None of it matters. Because you're experiencing is this luminosity, this spiritual light, as it were, from every situation, everything, totally no place where it is not. So how can you be bereft of anything? How can you be bereft? How can you be poor of it? Poor, that's your wealth. That is your wealth. How can you be poor? It's a new way of measuring wealth. When you have that wealth, How can you be said to be poor? Because you have now the solution to the continuity problem, which means you're released. You will be released from all dreams. And dreams are inherent poverty. Really, they are. So the only thing we should ask for is release from all dreams, from dreaming. All right. So, it's actually good news. Great news, actually. Great news here. Great news. Yeah, the times are incredibly severe. But it's exactly that time where you need to remain calm and focused and pray. Say, okay, what's the highest prayer I can pray? What's the highest focus I can focus on? Let me not panic. Let me just listen. And for me, it said, don't pray for outcomes. Don't pray for outcomes. Just reaffirm that spirit needs no outcomes. Spirit needs no outcomes. Spirit doesn't need any outcomes. God did not create spirit to need any outcomes. And spirit cannot change what it is. So therefore, spirit doesn't need any outcomes whatsoever. Spirit is not in need of any outcomes. Now, if you're able to pray on that level, just try it. You are then right there. And it's an easy step then to accept the vision of Christ. Easy step. Because, of course, at that point, outcomes will be meaningless to you. But as long as we're attached to outcomes, we'll be afraid of that vision because we'll look around and say, well, how do I get an outcome? I can't get a meaningful outcome out of anything. Everything has the same luminosity, so how can I get an outcome? You cannot. So you have to prepare yourself to affirm that spirit doesn't need outcomes. Affirm it. Just keep affirming it. Spirit does not need outcomes. Spirit does not need outcomes. What I am does not need any outcomes at all. And by affirming this, you're reminding yourself that you are spirit. You are spirit. And say, oh, yeah, I remember. I don't need outcomes. So you're not afraid of not finding outcomes and not being able to see outcomes. So we are going to go into this next phase here. We're into a next phase now, which is again, a quantum leap phase. Really. And it's not so cold tonight. It's like the warmest night's been in quite some time, which is wonderful. It's not freezing. I am spirit. I was created perfect. God did not create me to need any outcomes, did not create me with any problem that I needed an outcome for. Therefore, I don't need outcomes. I don't need to pray for any outcomes at all. I don't have to pray for a good outcome. I don't have to pray for a bad outcome. I don't have to pray for an indifferent outcome. I don't need to be concerned about outcomes at all. I don't need outcomes. I'm not in need of any outcomes. I don't need anything in particular to take place. It's not necessary for me to be what I am at all. And work at this angle. Work at this angle. And we will do that. We are doing that right now, and I can't wait to get this to develop further and to start blooming, because we can bloom right at this point, and it's not a minute too soon either. Really, not a minute too soon. We need to start blooming at this point, and there is the fertilizer, the bloom fertilizer. We can put on the plant that gets it to bloom. And it is the affirmations. It is using the right affirmations, which are just spirit reminding itself that it is spirit. That's all that affirmations really are. It's spirit saying, hey, I am spirit. Just say, hey, I am spirit. Yes, I am spirit. I don't need outcomes. I'm spirit. I don't need outcomes. I don't need any outcomes. Just say that. That is the most empowering thing anyone can say. I don't need any outcomes. Just to say that. And that, you don't know at this point how empowering that is, but I can tell you from what I've been experiencing recently, the last couple of weeks I've been doing these affirmations, it is incredibly empowering. And it leads directly to the vision of Christ, where you see this beautiful overlay, and you realize you don't need any outcomes at all. This is the one outcome you need, and you already have it. And it can't, nothing, no other outcome can take it away. No other outcome can take this away, you see. So you're safe. No more fear, no more worry, no more suffering. And literally just say, I am spirit. I do not need any outcomes. I do not need any outcomes, except, as we know, to solve the continuity problem. So We need that one outcome to solve. But I don't need any outcomes. I don't need outcomes at all. No outcomes. I don't need any outcomes. It's tacitly understood that by saying this, we free ourselves up to accept a vision in which we don't need any outcomes. Okay, that's understood. In other words, let's not use level confusion. Let's not get confused by levels. So you say, I am spirit. I don't need any outcomes. I am perfect as God created me. I don't need any outcomes at all. I don't need any outcomes. I don't need any outcomes. I'm not in need of any outcome of any type whatsoever. I don't need any outcomes. I'm not waiting for outcomes. I'm not expecting outcomes. I'm not hoping for outcomes. I'm not looking for them. There's zero necessity for any outcomes for me. Zero necessity. There's never been any necessity for any outcomes for what I am. Never. Never will be. Never will be a need for any outcomes whatsoever. And then the continuity issue is solved by seeing that, which by seeing it, we realize we don't have any need for any outcomes. That solves the continuity problem. Very simple. So we will continue on as fast as possible, faster than possible, actually, at this point. Pour the fertilizer on and keep on going. There's no time to stop right now at all. There's no time to get down on yourself. It is absolutely not time for that. It is time to expect success. It's time to expect success and use affirmations. Don't say anything negative. Say positive, like I have no need of outcomes. That's very positive. There's no need for any outcomes. No need for any outcomes. Affirm, and we will, I'll give help with this. But I just want to get this out here today to steady everything. Realize, hey, everybody, stay very steady. Be very steady right now. Very calm, very focused, very steady. And you may not realize that it's very close to resolving the entire situation. Okay, very great. Let's stop this video right here.